Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm very happy to be here, give a talk, and this is my first time to Russia. And I would like to thank for Grigory, Mashak, and to invite me to give a talk. And today my talk is about Bitcrypto analysis on symmetric ciphers. And my talk including the following issues. And first, I would like to introduce differential attack and include all differential attack, modular differential attack, and conditional differential attack. And then I would like to introduce Bitcrypto analysis in differential attack, linear attack, and the cube attack respectively, and then summarize the result on Kaczak's bound function, and finally is conclusion. And all differential attack is a classical differential attack, firstly introduced by Behrman and Shamir, which became a very powerful tool in crypto analysis for block cipher today. And the method aims to analyze how particular all differences in plain text pair affect the all differences of the resulting cipher text pairs. And it has been developed into many variants, which were used to analyze various cipher primitives. And the second method is the modular differential attack. Modular differential attack introduced to analyze hash functions by our group. The adversary cancels the unwanted avalanche arises from a given input difference by various bit carry control techniques and find specifically optimized differential path. And then we can determine a set of sufficient bit conditions to result in the specifically differential path. And finally, the attack can fulfill the various techniques, including message modifications, and to ensure more bit conditions hold. And this improves the success rate of the attack a lot. And the third is the conditional differential attack. This is introduced by the group of William Mir, and to analyze the stream ciphers, especially the non-linear feedback shift register-based crypto systems. And conditional differential attack, in fact, is also the differential attack combined bit conditions and message modification. This method also had been applied to analyze green, very famous stream ciphers, Trivium and Kata, hash, and some other weightlight block ciphers. And recently, it also used by Diner to analyze SPEC, the weightlight block ciphers designed by NSE. And the beta crypto analysis in differential attack, and we apply the beta crypto analysis to analyze semi, because semi is for round function is bitwise operation, so it is very easy to use the bitcrypto analysis technique. This is a joint work of the, my PhD student and me. And for the round function, it is for the round function, it is very similar, simple because the function only include the shift the shift circularly and or bitwise the operation. And we give the bit equations about round function. Xj plus n and this is the equations. And this is the key schedules. And we have a very important observation that if we give it two inputs of the S round, the S round input difference is delta xi minus 1. And for the equation, the S round equation output difference is delta x I plus 1. We consider the bit equation delta x j plus n I plus 1 equal to b. B is 0 or 1. And we can find the solutions of two bit sub k because the equation has two sub k bits. We want to find the solutions of two bit sub k. And usually have four solutions, but by the bit conditions, we can prove that we only find 0.75 bit, less than 1 bit for the equation. And for the first case, there is no solutions. It means that we don't guess any sub k bit. We can check whether the equation hold. And for the second case, and only there are four solutions. And for the third case, there is only two solutions. It means that only one bit k in the equations. And the fourth is and fifth step case also there is one k in the equation, not two bit k. This means that we can reduce the number of subcase bits guessed depending to the specific values in the selected path. And use the observation and we can consider the differential path is given by Bell curve. And we can deduce if we add four rounds on the top and four rounds at the bottom, enlarge the differential path, we can deduce the first four paths and the last four paths, deduce all the bit conditions. And we know that there are 10 conditions on the input difference independent of the k bits, and also deduce 10 conditions on ciphertext difference. These 20 conditions are independent of sub-k bits, has no relation with the k. And there are totally 28 conditions from the round 2 to 4 round, and the last three rounds, which are related to sub K bits. So we need to guess the sub K bits in the 28 conditions involved in the 28 conditions. There are totally 50 bits of sub K involved in the 28 conditions. But for the before, the previous attack usually guessed the 15 bits, but our method only guess 24.26 bits. We only guess half bits, not all the bits, K bits. This is our method. And for example, for the equation delta x 21 to equal to 0 means that we open the equation. We open the equation. And because x 29 equal to 0, we deduce that for the first case, no solutions. No solution. So we didn't. We don't need to guess any k bits. And for the second case, only two solutions, not for the solution. And for the third case, two cases, and only one solution, only one solution. So, only one case has two solutions. But for the previous attack, every case has two solutions. But for our method, only one case has two solutions. And for this, for delta x 32 equal to 0, we open the equation. And we can find the solutions to the equation. And only 0.75 bit k bit guessing. But the before the attack need to guess 2 bit. But this method only guess 1.75 bit. And use the bit conditions, we can construct these structures. I don't give the details for the data, the concept, to the construction of the data structure. And but use our method, we can deduce the time complexity. 就是 use the bit conditions, we can deduce the time complexity of the constructing data structure. And we use the bit crypt analysis technique to semi versions, all the versions. We can attack 2 to 4 more rounds in the previous attack. This is all. Of our result. And totally about more than 1,000 bit equations for the attacks. And the synced work is to introduce the bit crypt analysis in linear attack. This work is accepted by FSE this year. And this is also joint work, my PhD student and me. And usually, like the differential attack, we also to reduce the key guessing space. And we give a very simple example. We give a very simple example. For this function f, we know that there is two k-bit k0, k1, and two message bit x0, x1. So usually we compute the bias of y in the linear attack. It is very important to compute the bias of y. And the previous method is the time complexity is 2^4 computations. But by the bit conditions, we only use the 2^3 computations, half computations to compute the bias of y. And from the case 1, 2, 3, we can compute the bias of y from t0, t1. And we consider this linear x big R, 5i to x big I, the round 13, I plus 13 for this linear half. And we compute all the active bits. Every active bit is an equation. Each active bit is an equation. And for all the active bits, we deduce all the bit conditions. And then we guess the key bits, guess the key bit. For example, for the fxk, it is very complex. Although it is very complex, but we can deduce the key guessing like this. Like this. This is the right line is the key need to guess. We can use this. For example, if we guess K1, K3, K7, and the F can be simplified to this equation. It seems that it is simple. It is very simple. It is simplified than this equation. This equation is very complex, but if we only guess 3 k-bits, the equation is very simple, very, very simple. And then we guess k5, k14, and the function is simplified again. So we not guess all the k-bits, only guess partial k-bits, and the function is very simple, and we can compute the bias of the function. So, for the linear attack, we can compute the time complexity like this. This is the summary of linear hard attack on semi. It is improved about total 7 rounds than the previous attack in our linear hard attack. And it is very hard for us to attack more rounds about seminal because the bit conditions is very have the obviously advantage than the differential attack and linear attack. And we also use the bit crypt analysis technique in cube attack. In fact, the cube attack is given by the Professor Shamir and his colleagues. So it is very, very important method to analyze stream surfers, also to analyze some wavelet block surfers today. And we hope to use the bit conditions to improve the attacks, the clearing attack and the catch-up MAC to recover the key. And we know that for the right, it is natural the avalanche for input only 2-bit non-zero difference. But for the third round, it is very complex for the output difference. But for the left, we use the bit conditions. We use the bit conditions. The avalanche is reduced a lot. The left is less avalanche. The right is heavy avalanche. Because the left uses the bit conditions to slow down the propagation like this. This is our bit conditions. We use this bit conditions because we select, we get some key bits. We get some key bits and we select, we choose some RV bits. And guarantee this condition is hold. This condition hold. And the avalanche is reduced greatly. And we hope to use this result to improve the attack, previous attack. And we also find some new cube variable because for cube attack we need to find the cube variables. So we find nine variables. We find we find the nine variables to use the to fulfill the cube attack. And this is the summarize of our key recovery attack on catch-up MAC. And in Eurocrypt last year, and the cube attack on catch-up MAC is works for 5, 6, 7 rounds. And for our attack, we also use the cube attack with the bit conditions, with our bit conditions. And we improve the attack. For 5 rounds, our attack is total 24 power. Computations and data complexity all the same. And for 6, our attack is total power 40, and the previous attack is total 66 computations. And for 7 round MAC, we give the attack with time complexity total power 72 computations. And before, the computation is total 97 computations. This is use bit conditions in cube attack can improve the existing attacks. And we also use our attack to the key recovery attack on Kayak. It is authentication encryption algorithm. Encryption authentication new encryption or authentication algorithm. And our attack first works on 8 round. 8 round on Kayak. Our computation time computation is the total power 74. It is also efficient, very efficient for the 8 round algorithm, Kayak. And we also use our method to the distinguishing attack on Kaichak sponge function. And before, the attack only works for 6 rounds, but our attack can work for 7 rounds. And the time complexity and the data complexity is very, very efficient, is total power 33 computations. Finally, I would give the conclusions. The bitcrypt analysis, including the all differential attack with bit conditions of module differential attack. Usually, bitcrypt analysis, some algorithm only has bitwise operation. This case, we use the differential attack combined bit conditions is enough. If the algorithm including the add operation not bitwise operation, we need use the differential attack combined with the bit conditions and also use the bit carry conditions, also use the message modification, and we can improve the attacks for some algorithm. And usually, bitcrypt analysis is available to dynamic key guessing technique and remove the redundancy of subkeys by bit conditions, which are more actual method. Reduce the key guessing space. So the bitcrypt analysis is more powerful than searching the differential path, even with the automatic searching technique. My talk is over. Thanks.